StudyItOnline.com/LiveWire.
Did you hear about my experience with former Washington Mayor Marion Barry?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I had an experience with Marion Barry. Several!
Barry died on Sunday at the age of 78. He was elected mayor of Washington 4 times, and during one of his terms, Barry was caught on camera in a hotel room smoking crack and groping a woman who was not his wife. When undercover agents stormed the room, Barry uttered 4 words that nobody ever forgot. Bitch set me up. And just a few months ago, Barry told a Washington television station why voters kept reelecting him despite all of the scandal that surrounded him.
To a lot of people in this town, I'm a hero, I'm a savior, and I'm a supporter for seniors and young people and black middle class, and, you know, that's why people love me so much.
A few years after spending time in prison, Barry had an amazing comeback and was elected mayor of Washington again. Eventually, he left office, the mayor's office, and became a city councilman. And that's when I met him as a city councilman who wore a dashiki, one of those West African outfits. It was the mid-90s. It's a little hazy for me, that time period of my life. But I used to, I was an intern and a part-time reporter as a teenager for WPGC in Washington. It was my first big break. And I used to call him at 6 o'clock in the morning to do phone interviews with him, and then I'd cut up the sound, and we'd play clips of the interviews. So one time, I got really gutsy, and I invited him to lunch.
God, that's so unlike
you. That'd be the weirdest lunch.
Oh, it was weird. I was like 17 years old. And we had lunch. Not only did I invite him to lunch, I invited him to one of the fanciest restaurants in Washington, and the Hotel Washington. And he brought a lady friend.
Oh, he did.
I did not invite that person, so I had to pay for 2 people. A little rude. He ate a plate of fruit. And we really didn't talk that much because I didn't know what to talk to him about. I was 17 years old. I just thought
it's the best story ever.
It's so awkward.
I just thought, you know, kind of maybe enhance our relationship, and he would talk more on the radio.
Right. You always have these grandiose thoughts, like we're gonna go to lunch, we're gonna hit it off.
Yeah, but
he's gonna give me all the nuggets. I'll be invited over for the holidays, and then it never, you know.
But I think today Josh would be more self-aware, right? He would know if this happens, it's gonna be so awkward, right?
Yeah.
Did you imagine taking a car ride with Josh? Just even a half an hour. It's got to be just
the most excruciating, awkward thing ever. Yeah.
So now he's decided he's going to, he wanted to ingratiate himself to this guy. He didn't know himself,
though. Hey, I give you credit for asking, though, man. And he accepted. You went to lunch with Marion Barry.
Yeah, so after lunch, the bill was $60. I saved the receipt, by the way, and I submitted it to the radio station, and I wrote on the expense sheet, the reason for the lunch was to enhance the radio station's relationship with Marion Barry, and my boss made fun of me, but he ended up paying the bill. Marion Barry and I, we walked back to his office, and we took a picture. Mm-hmm. The whole thing was
Where's the picture?
It's on my Twitter page, at Josh Spiegel.
Whoa.
You can see a picture of...
And you're 17?
Yeah, about 17.
Do you have a big Jufro?
Yes. Yes, I do.
I can't wait to see it.
And Barry has a dashiki. And, you know, maybe he just didn't know what to make of me, but the whole thing was very awkward, and we took this picture in his office, and then I went on my way, and he went on his way, and...
And then, did you have to continue doing the phone calls to interview?
Yes, I did.
Probably
worse. So then what happened from that?
You probably made it worse.
Yeah, right. From that point on, was it just, like, now super awkward?
No. He was a very guarded man. I think he just didn't trust the media, but I probably made it worse just because I'm very awkward myself.
They had a third person there. That usually helps.
The woman was his lady friend.
There's the picture. I got to
retweet around,
that.
Coming around.
The lady friend was a little more talkative than Marion Barry.
Look at Spiegs. God, you almost look normal.
Well,
yeah,
I was.
He actually
was
looks kind of attractive.
Happened.
Yeah.
When did you start to go weird, dude?
Well, I don't know what that means.
I mean, that guy could pull some chicks, the guy in that picture.
This guy. The young, vibrant Spiegs.
Look at him.
I had balls. Not only, look, I don't like talking about myself.
No,
but
of course not.
Not only did I have lunch with Marion Barry, I had lunch with the Surgeon General when I was 17
Every
or 18.
Coop?
No, it was a Latino woman.
Dude, you could have been a mover and a shaker.
The Washington police chief.
Look at you. You could have been a mover
and
a shaker.
Yeah, I could have. I could have, but something went horribly wrong.
I'm trying
wrong.
To figure out. We,
why didn't you write down things to talk about? Did you just thought you were going to come in and just nail it? Because if I'm Josh, I'm like, all right.
Well, you don't write them down. You at least, you know, think of some stock, you know, small talk questions or something. Here's my thing, though. I figured it out. It's like from first grade all the way up until about 12 or 13 is just a blur. Something happened there. You were very reserved. You were an introvert. Then when you found radio, it kind of was your it is where you belong.
You're coming out.
You started to come out, and then here at 17, you felt you had been doing it for 4, 5, 6 years. You felt like you were pretty decent at it. You were taking some risks. You were moving and shaking. You were asking people to lunch. And then somewhere along the way, something... I mean, you're still amazing at what you do. You're the best ever at it, but...
But you're not inviting someone to lunch.
Right. Some ways, something went off the rails.
Do you think it was sitting in silence eating a fruit plate? Do you think this could have been...
Maybe this was the moment.
Yeah. Right. But one other thing, not to call more attention
to
myself.
No.
I did an interview with the director of the FBI.
Look at this guy.
In his office. I was 17 or 18 years in his office at FBI headquarters. I got to drive into underground, into the whole thing. I've had such a wonderful life. just like the movie. And it's now all over. StudyItOnline.com.